Hi there. Welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I'd like to take a few minutes to show you a really nice, a newer floor plan actually for Sunseeker. This is a Forest River product. The model is a 2550. So it's got a really nice layout, sort of in that mid-size range. But as you can see, when we get inside, it's got a really usable floor plan. For a coach this size, I think somebody really thought this one through when they designed this. So good balance between livability and drivability. Maybe you like to get into some spots where a bigger motorhome isn't really applicable, so this could be a good option for you. We like Forest River products. It's part of Berkshire Hathaway, so they're a manufacturer that's backed by a good financial stable umbrella, so to speak. In today's environment, that's always a big plus. We like, as a dealership, we like to put our inventory into manufacturers that we feel like are going to be around for the long haul. So since they're backed by Warren Buffett's financial backing, we figure that's a pretty good bet. If he runs out of money, I guess it probably doesn't really matter for any of us. But anyway, that's kind of a side issue, but as a consumer, it's kind of nice to know that too, so that, you know, 3 or 4 years down the road, you know, you can look back and say, I'm glad I didn't buy a coach from a manufacturer that was kind of a upstart, fly-by-night, whatever the case may be, and find out that they're not around anymore in case you have some issues. This one is built on a Ford platform, so it's on the E450 chassis, so you got a good solid foundation for the motorhome. It's powered by V10, 6.8 liter Triton V10, so you got plenty of power, good performance, good layout. As you can see, as we look down the side of it, you've got a nice big patio awning, great place to set a couple chairs out here. Usually this is kind of where you're going to be hanging out when you're at the campsite. There's a spot for your propane. Got storage pretty much all the way around the coach. And they use a nice rotocast material, so it's a hard plastic, easy to keep clean, and doesn't, you know, it's a really low maintenance. This unit has two slide outs. We'll see once we go inside how that lays out, but that does help for the livability. I've got storage compartment here and on the other side, and there is a pass through over the top there. Maybe you could slide something in there, like a table, or maybe you got some long fishing poles or some oars or something along those lines. Does have a ladder to get up on top, here on the back of the coach. They use a one-piece fiberglass roof on these coaches also, so they're real durable, less maintenance involved with the fiberglass roof, less chance you're gonna poke a hole in it. Does have a nice heavy-duty hitch on it. They put a 7,500 pound hitch on these, again with that chassis. Got a heavy chassis and good power trains to be able to tow maybe a boat or a vehicle behind it. Here's your other side of that storage compartment. Then you got your power cord in here. You'd have 30 amp service on your power. A couple of more storage compartments over on this side. Got one up in here in the slide out. Notice it does have a awning cover over the slide out also. And then this is probably one of your larger compartments right here on the coach. See, a nice big compartment. Pretty long and fairly deep. Then over here, we've got your generator. It has a 4,000 watt Onan gasoline power generator, so that's going to run off your main gasoline fuel tank, so you don't have to have separate fuel sources for that. I like the fact this one has side view cameras as well as a backup monitor, so I can see what's going on the side of my coaches, of my side of my coach when I'm going down the road. As soon as I turn my blinker on, actually, it'll display that side of the motorhome. I think that's a really nice feature for when you're trying to switch lanes, eliminates blind spots. So again, sort of the combination of drivability and livability. So let's see about the livability. You may have questions somewhere along the line. only have so much time to go over what we can go over on this video, so feel free to give me a call. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. That's my direct line. Come on in, let's take a look. So the cab's user-friendly. This is 2021 model, so fresh off the press. This one's, we haven't had on the lot very long. They're just now starting to see the newer 21 models come in. Nice, easy, friendly dash. You got your backup monitor right there. Notice the nice big area over the cab. Plenty of room for a couple people to sleep up there. Got windows on both sides, storage compartments, even has a little cup holders up in there. So you may or may not use this, but if you want to have the ability to sleep more people, this is a great little place. Kids would love to sleep there. Now the dinette makes into a bed also, so you do have the ability to put somebody in here too. So if you need to sleep quite a few people, you do. Look at the size of that. Comes out country mile. This will just drop down and you can use these cushions to fill in to make another bed. That's probably the last bed you're going to use, but with the overhead and the queen size bed in the back, you got plenty of places to sleep people. This one back here does not make into a bed. Take a look at all that storage. I mean, the whole slide out overhead storage, fairly deep, plenty good compartment doors too, so you've got good access to lots of storage. Got a little shelf back here. So we do have one more bed here as well. This one is a sleeper also. It's kind of a, what you call a scissor bed, so it just pops out pretty easy to operate. So you've got 1, 2, 3, 4 beds in this coach. Like I said, it really kind of gives you a good balance of being able to take the whole gang, have some, you know, comfortable place for everybody. Nice comfortable seats. TV right across from here. This also has some storage behind it. It swings out. Look at all that storage. Got a huge storage compartment back there. Good place to maybe put some of your favorite movies in case you're out and you get some foul weather. You can stay inside for a while, ride out the storm, watch a movie or two. It's a nice thing about having an RV. Got heat and air conditioning to be able to brave the elements. Lots of storage in the kitchen area too. One of the things that I think is kind of impressive about this is for a 25-foot coach, it's got a nice amount of counter space. So for those of you who like to kind of work in the kitchen, some people don't spend much time in the kitchen when they're out. Maybe just cook outdoors or not. But for those that do, it's nice to have some space to be able to work. Nice deep stainless steel sink, 3-burner stovetop with the cover here too that you can use for additional storage. And then it has a microwave convection oven. So, oh, got her taped up there, I guess. Still in the wrapper, so, but you get the idea. So, propane stovetop, microwave convection oven, and the refrigerator is a 10 cubic foot, so you got a good size refrigerator with a freezer up on top, separate, plenty of room for some goodies in there where you can get plenty of ice cream or treats or whatever the case may be. A good size refrigerator with compartments on the side here too. Now this is operates off 12 volt. So that's a big plus too, because it's gonna, you don't have to be plugged in for if you do a lot of dry camping. That makes it nice. You can run this right off your 12 volt. And there's some more storage down there. Oh, and then I guess we didn't really touch on this, but right above the door, you've got your entertainment center right there and the convenience center. So I can access my tank levels right here. I can turn my generator on from right here. Hot water heater, which is actually gas or electric, so I can run it off either side. Does have a, I can turn my water pump on here. I've got lighting. and my slide controls right here also, and then some more lights. And then you've got a little spot out there where you could probably plug in, like if you decided you wanted to put a operate some kind of a TV system. Maybe you wanted to have DirecTV or Dish Network. You want satellite TV. You could put your receiver up there because it's got the outlets for it. This is pretty nice too. For again, for this size motorhome, lots of storage. I've got kind of a pantry here, and then over on this side, it's a little deeper side and more bigger. Yeah. It's a larger pantry, a little deeper, bigger compartments. Notice lots of drawers. They're full extension, nice heavy-duty metal glides. A little bit more like what you'd expect at home. Bathroom has a shower with the skylight over it, so we've got some nice natural light coming in. Toilet, sink, all in one. And the bedroom actually has a queen size bed. I like all the windows back here too, so you've got lots of natural light again. Storage above that bed, and then you have another closet. Actually, this is a good size closet for hanging clothes, and a little shelf down below. Great layout. You know, like I said, maybe you're looking for something kind of in that mid-size range. This could be a good opportunity, maybe a brand new 2021. Feel free to give me a call. If you have any other questions, you can reach me at 541-510-1017. Thanks.